Today I'm going to tell you what a nuclear physicist and the search for aliens can teach us about finding love. Alright, so scientists don't know exactly how love works or what it does to our brains, but that's all a topic for another show. What we do know is that in every culture we've looked at, almost everyone on Earth goes out looking for love. With 7 billion other humans out there, why can love be so hard to find? Sometimes you feel like saying, where is everybody? And that's exactly what Enrico Fermi asked, except that he was talking about alien life. He thought, with billions of stars and planets in the galaxy, 13 billion years should be plenty of time for a civilization to stop by and say, hey, welcome to the neighborhood. It's called Fermi's paradox. An astronomer named Frank Drake took Fermi's question and answered it with an equation, because that's what astronomers do. He said if you plug in a little bit of data about the galaxy, you can make an estimate of how many civilizations there might be out there. Let's go play with Drake's equation and see what we come up with. N star, the number of stars in the Milky Way. A lower guess puts that at 100 billion. F sub p is the fraction of stars that have planets, which NASA now says is as high as 100%, or a planet for every star. N sub e is the number of those planets that could support life as we know it. A recent estimate puts that at 2.5 billion, or 4%. That leaves us with F sub little l, the fraction of those that actually develop life. Recent estimate says as high as 13%. F sub I is the fraction that have intelligence. F sub C is the fraction that develop technology. F sub big L is the fraction of time a civilization exists before it destroys itself. And those are pretty hard to guess, but we can use Carl Sagan's numbers because we can trust Carl. Put it in your calculator and you get 52,000 possible spacefaring civilizations. Yes, it's a guess, but it's a scientific guess, so it's okay. Now, I think it means we've got no reason to feel lonely if we're just optimistic. But what about finding another life form here, on Earth? Can you calculate your odds of finding that special someone, or maybe many special someones? Let's say you're a 25-year-old woman named Anne who lives in New York City. N sub P is her target population, or 8,244,910 people from New York. F sub G is the fraction of Anne's target gender, which is about 50% no matter her preference, unless it's both, then she'd plug in 100%. Approximately 44% of Americans are single at any time, so plug that in for F sub S since Anne's not looking to break up any couples. F sub E is the fraction Anne might encounter, which would be small if she only goes out to meet people at bars or parties, but about 37% of singles use online dating, so that maximizes her chances. Based on the age divided by 2 plus 7 rule and the creepy old guy rule, Anne's looking for someone between 20 and 34, which is 24.7% of New Yorkers, or F sub Y. Anne wants someone who speaks English, 96% for F sub L. F sub A is the fraction of people Anne finds attractive, a very subjective number that an online poll of my friends says is about 13% for the average person who happens to be friends with me. Then there's F sub A2, the number of people that think Anne's attractive, so 13% again. Anne also wants someone who shares her love of science, so at the very least it has to be one of the 32.4% of New Yorkers with a college degree, F sub I. Crunch the love numbers and there's 871 special someones out there for Anne. Like maybe this guy with the dark hair and turtleneck. Of course, like any equation, there's a factor we call X. Are they funny? Do they share your political beliefs? Do they prefer Star Trek or Star Wars? Maybe your last relationship didn't go well and you've got a crazy X factor. The more rules you make for how you define love, the fewer special people there are out there for you to find.
So if we keep an open mind when it comes to the search for life and love, there's a lot to be hopeful about. Sometimes the galaxy can feel like a big, lonely place. Like that guy with the turtleneck reminds us, for small creatures such as we, the vastness is bearable only through love. So how many people are out there that you could love?
Billions, billion, trillions, trillion, million, 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 billion, 400 billion suns, billion, trillion, million, billion, trillions of orbiting snowballs, billion, 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 trillions,
million, million, million,